Can you trust Kurzgesagt videos? To answer this question, we'll first explain how we research them and then talk a bit about past videos and what we want to achieve with the channel. Making a Kurzgesagt video always begins with a question or an issue. For example, after our meat video, many viewers asked about the health effects of meat on humans. We had no idea and were pretty curious too, so we just decided to work on it. The first step is research. We start by looking for books and scientific papers to get an overview and just read a lot. The plan is to find a story worth telling. Is there something surprising to learn? Is there a larger context or a new perspective? Or will it be an overview or introduction? Once we have the first readable version, we reach out to experts or scientists and ask them to fact-check and correct us. Often enough, they find a flaw or point us in the direction of contradictory research. At this point, many scripts die. If our idea does hold up, we continue working on it. This process can take weeks or months. Our loneliness script, for example, took over a year and a half to finish. The hardest part is being brief while not simplifying too much. It's much easier to write a long script than a short one. When we're finally done, we do another round of research.
In my opinion, I think Kurzgesagt walks a very fine line. too complex, too simple. And it's a massive problem because, especially when you're doing videos on physics, which there's a lot of on his channel, it's you nearly always have to distill it to a point where it is actually misinformation. Almost always when you watch a physics video or an astro, like any area of physics on YouTube, you're probably getting misinformation. Why? Because we have to distill it in a way that our human brains can sort of understand it. And a lot of the time, take quantum theory, general relativity, we speak so loosely about this stuff because talking about it requires years of mathematical knowledge and the concepts build upon each other, and you just really can't even talk about it in any accurate way. And so whether it's from, you know, simplifying the structure of an atom to simplifying how the Big Bang to simple, like everything, it's a problem. PBS Spacetime, I disagree with you. I think Kurzgesagt actually has a better balance than Spacetime because these videos are much more entertaining. These videos are open to more people. PBS Spacetime is an incredible channel, but it's way more focused for people who have already some prerequisite knowledge. These videos are accessible to anyone, kids to very old. And they're not only just inform you in terms of like basic stuff, they also occasionally tell you some actually really things, you know, you'd only get from a professor. And so this is an incredible balance. And they've got the animations which make it so watchable. The watch time on these videos would be unbelievably high. So I think this guy should win a Nobel Prize in science communication if there was a thing. And I think there should be a fucking thing because science communication is just as important as the science. If you do brilliant science but you never communicate it to someone else, well then guess what? It was as good as pointless because no one will ever know. No one will ever be able to understand. And maybe eventually someone will come along and decipher what you've done. That's what's happened a lot of times in the history of science. You have some really smart dude in math or woman, and you know they'll discover something, and they just are so introverted they can't communicate. That's it.
Search and show the script to experts again, ideally different ones than the ones we talked to at the beginning of the process. When we express an opinion, we mark it as such. That's not saying that we don't draw conclusions from the research. Homeopathy does not work, and meat is really bad for the planet. Climate change is real, but organic food is not a good way of solving it. If the facts clearly support a conclusion, it's okay to present it as such. Of course, we can't always make everybody happy. People who know a lot about a topic sometimes get annoyed if we don't mention an aspect they think is crucial or when we omit technical terms. This is more or less unsolvable because of the nature of our videos. Scripts have around one...
That's a great way to put it. It's impossible because it's what we were just talking about. You've got to misinform to some degree, and scientists don't understand this. There are so many people in the depths of the fields doing the research and they don't understand anything about science communication because we don't get forced to do it in a degree, and we should. And, you know, these people don't understand that we need to actually distill it and misinform to some degree.
1,300 words, so there's always some degree of simplification. You will always find a list of our research and sources and further reading material in the video description. Just citing sources doesn't make your work accurate or your research good though, so we encourage you to use our sources document as a starting point to look at the topic yourself and learn more. But it would be dishonest to say that we've always worked this way. Some older videos don't live up to the standards we set ourselves today. The two that annoy us the most are the refugee and addiction videos. In both of them, we didn't try to present a balanced perspective, but instead chose a take and ran with it. The refugee video was made with a deep feeling of angry frustration about the world at the high point of the 2015 refugee crisis. While we argued over quotas, dead children washed ashore on our coastlines. The script was written on one Sunday afternoon and illustrated and animated within a week. It was exhausting, stressful, and frustrating. We still believe it was the right thing for European countries to help, but it was absolutely unnecessary to be toxic about it. We insulted people and brushed away their concerns about real and profound challenges. The video was divisive and emotional at a time when the debate needed a calm and clear overview. The addiction video was based on only one source that has amassed a lot of criticism over the years.
I don't know about what he just said about the refugee stuff. I think I disagree in a lot of places there, but we'll save that.
And unfortunately, we did not reach out to scientists or do extra research on the papers that were the basis for the video's thesis, that addiction is purely psychological and based on the life circumstances of the individual. This stance is still held by a number of addiction professionals, and we're not saying it's wrong, but a lot of others disagree, and it's not correct to present it as the truth. Addiction is far from solved, and our video should have reflected that instead of taking one side. We simplified an idea so much that it made a great story, but became distorting. Both videos were made over the span of 2 months, and they're
not distorting, I just made it extremely wrong.
Of our most successful.
More wrong than is acceptable, because all of it is going to be, it's not all of it, but most of it's going to be somewhat wrong, but it's going to be not too wrong.
Four videos to date. We had found a formula that really worked, but we never made anything like them again.
I don't know if it's like watching your old cringy videos. I think what they're actually talking about is, they just presented, they realized they were a bit, too hard one way or the other. They might have been having a bad day, or they felt really impassioned by some, refugee crisis, right? And like they said, they pumped it out very quickly. And yeah, so I don't think it's actually like a cringy video. I'm sure they probably still agree with it, the person who wrote it, right? Maybe he's changed his mind or something. But maybe the backlash caused them to realize, okay, people don't want this, or it's too, jarring for a lot of people, so we're just going to present things in a more agnostic way, which is what they generally do, I think, nowadays. Which I think is, it's good and bad.
And have been discussing how to deal with them for a long time. It doesn't help that both videos are loved by many people. We want to be proud of our work, and these two videos don't make us proud. So today, we deleted them. It won't purge them from the internet, but that's not the goal anyway. Feel free to upload them elsewhere. We're working on a new addiction video that will take a look at the chemical and psychological causes. We'll take our sweet time with it, so please have patience. The refugee video is not up to date anymore, so we will not renew it. We're also going through our older videos to add sources, further reading, and comments in the next few months. Nowadays, rather than trusting in mainstream institutions, we often look at creators on the internet for reliable information. We rely on the fact that they're careful and rigorous and not led by monetary incentives. And we expect them to acknowledge mistakes in public and work.
What a load of shit. Everyone's incentivized by the money. You know what I mean? Like, everyone. We're humans, man. Yeah, a major part of my motivation is to actually help. But, it's like, I'm already doing that in the physics, in the PhD, you know what I mean? So it's sort of like, we get no money in the PhD or the physics area, so a lot of us are trying to other areas to kind of to survive, I got to disagree, push back a little bit. Money is in the way the world works is important, unfortunately. You know, you can't survive without it. Well, you can. You can go live in Alaska, and I'd love to do that. But unfortunately, you know, what else did we say? We're almost done, I think.
To minimize them. So this is what we're going to do.
You should come. I'm building something as well, actually, for the sake of people. This isn't to make money. I saw that something that needed to be done. So quantum computers are right around the corner, the powerful ones. They already exist. So I created this little VPN, and it's got something called post-quantum cryptographic algorithms in it. And these are quite new. NIST has just advised everyone upgrade their encryption standards. And we're the first VPN that consumers can use with them, which is kind of cool. And I'm proud of it. So if you want to come help us out, but you do you.
Trust is not a thing you earn once and then keep forever. You have to constantly work for it. So can you trust Kurzgesagt? You can trust that every video we make is thoroughly researched and approved by different experts. You can trust that we know that we have biases and we try to overcome them. We want to move Kurzgesagt further towards the trustworthy end of the spectrum. The world is too complex for simple answers, and we don't want to be the ones giving them. Making these videos over the last 6 years has been quite a ride, and we're very grateful for it.
The world might be simpler than we realize, though.
We hope you'll be with us for the next few years too, and join us on our journey to figure out what this universe and life stuff is all about. Thank you.
I think you can trust Kurzgesagt. They're great videos. You can trust they're going to inform, misinform you to the minimal degree possible. Because they will misinform you, like I've been stating in this video, but it's going to be the least misinformed videos probably on YouTube in some way. So that's good. I mean, if you want to go really deeper, yeah, like Adam said before, go check out PBS Spacetime if you like that specific area of, you know, physics, of science. They go in depth. But it's hard to follow. So, that's a Kurzgesagt video done. That was awesome.